my team turn.
Take me out on the water.
We fishing.
Way out in the woods. Where the breathing is easy, the living is good. Out in the great outdoors.
Welcome to Larry Smith Outdoors. We're sponsored by the Badger Sportsman Magazine, Bartline Barrels, Warrior Boats, Lynch of McGuanago, Big Snow Resort, Hard and Soft Fishing, Suzuki, Wings Over Wisconsin, Dick Smith's Bait and Tackle, Kamik Law Firm, Kamalan Measuring Tools, Vexlar, Cold Snap, Norm's Egg, and Jiffy.
And remember, it's a great day to be alive.
Holy moly.
Hey, good morning and welcome to Larry Smith Outdoors. This morning we're doing something totally different. What we're going to do is we're going to be doing an ice rescue, and we're with our good friend Adam Walton here from Pike Pole Guide Service and the Janesville Fire Department. And Adam, tell everybody what we're up to this morning.
Well, this morning we're going to fall through the ice intentionally without any protective gear on, so no wetsuit or anything. The only thing we do have in place are obviously our life jackets for safety reasons. But other than that, we're going to try to do a real life demo of what happens to your body when you fall through the water, the cold water shock aspect of it, and how it takes your breath away, and then how, when that breath returns to you after about 2 minutes, how to formulate a plan and how to get out. This is made more for deeper water. Obviously, if you fall through shallow water and you can get out somewhat quick, do so. But if you can't, we want you to try to follow these steps. We're going to show you how to get out with ice picks, and then Larry's also going to demonstrate some other tactics,
with
too.
A nebulous, and a little backstroke here, too. So, yeah, it's a very, it's something that we've never done before, and over the course of my, 30 years of ice guiding, I've actually gone through myself about a half a dozen times. So, and I always, with the main thing, like you said, Adam, the biggest thing is don't panic.
Absolutely.
So let's show everybody what happens this morning here, and stay tuned. Let's see what happens. You going in first?
I think I'll go in first. And we got the Janesville Fire Department here, so hopefully we're safe. We got the ice. We got plenty of things in place here. We got divers in the water and the Gumby guys, so they'll be watching our backs too. So.
And we appreciate the Janesville Fire Department Rescue coming down today and giving us a hand. Hey, Adam, I got a feeling that this ice is a little weaker going on my side, because look how much taller you are than
me. Yeah, maybe that's the reason.
You must be on better ice than
I
do.
Yeah, that's exactly.
Hey, stay tuned. Let's see what happens this morning on Larry Smith Outdoors. So the interesting part about our show is that every week we do a live Facebook feed too. So I make sure that everybody subscribes, right? Or likes us on Facebook. And you'll get a notification every week when we do these different types of things. Like today, we're going through the water on this ice rescue. Obviously in the next 2 months, we're gonna be doing a weekly ice fishing live feed too. So, it's just all part of our show. Anything that we can do to get more people interested in the outdoors, that's what it's all about. Hey, Adam. We've got our diver. Now, it looks like he's struggling to get underneath that ice. So what's actually happening there?
So it's a little shallow right there. So he's trying to get himself in between the ice and the bottom.
Okay.
And then once he gets through there, he'll get going. He's a little bit buoyant right away with all his equipment on. So he's got to get that underneath the ice shelf.
Okay.
And then they'll do a comms check, because they have a mic'd up mask. So they'll make sure everything's working right. Make sure you can read all his air regulations,
right,
all that stuff right. Before he takes off, and now he's directing him out, so he's swimming straight out, and he'll be right underneath here,
almost
underneath the nebula.
Holy cats, that's interesting. I should have brought him some Christmas cookies this morning. He wouldn't be so buoyant.
Yeah, maybe.
Right? It is a little nerve-wracking, just because even though we have all these safety precautions here, but anytime you're going through, and like I said, it's such a shock to your system when your whole body hits that cold, icy water.
I'm not going to be able to speak for a minute, just because it's going to suck the air out of my lungs. But as soon as I can, I will start trying to demonstrate some tactics on how to get out. So first, you're going to see me try to control my breathing, and that's going to be my only goal. Keep my head above water, control my breathing, and then we'll work on getting out.
Hey, Adam, just one quick thing. Why did all your fellow fighters here and rescue guys clap when you said you're not going to be able to speak for a minute? All right?
All right, you ready?
All right. Woo! As you can see, how that takes your breath away.
I forgot my cell phone. No, just kidding. Just kidding. My stomach's cramping up pretty hard. I got a diver coming by me. But we're good. Okay. All right. So my breathing, starting to get a little bit under control. So my whole goal now, my body's tingling, it's burning really bad, my stomach's cramping up.
Yep.
My breathing's a little bit better now. It took.
So you got acclimated.
Yep, it's getting acclimated now. So, all right. So now I can start thinking about what I want to do to get out of here. Got my goal, kept my head above water.
And that's the main thing right there.
My main thing right there.
Yep.
So now I'm ready to rock and roll. So I know the ice was mostly safe the way I came in on. So what I'm gonna do is retrace my tracks. So I wanna come in where I came in at, was about right here. And ice may break off as I try to get up, and that's fine, and it's fairly common. What you wanna do is break that off, push it to the side. Eventually you're gonna get on to some solid ice, and when you do so, that's where we're gonna try to get out. So the first thing I'm gonna try to do is to get my body up on top of the ice and then kick my legs simultaneously so I'm in a line and try to shoot out straight onto the ice. So it's gonna be hard to do without picks. It's pretty slippery, and yes, I do have picks on, but I'm gonna show you that if I can get out here first without picks. So up and breaks off.
Okay.
Push it away.
Right. You're just trying to get to the yep. state, the better ice that'll hold your body.
Right. Okay. Chicken. See how slippery this is.
And the ice is actually blowing down a little yep. bit. Nice
so
job.
I want to disperse my weight. Don't get up right away. Disperse your weight.
Roll
away until you're on safe ice.
Oh. Woo. Nice. Nice job.
And get out. So,
if
you have picks.
Yep.
We're gonna do this.
You're gonna do it again, huh?
We'll do it again.
Okay. Now watch that ice bowl underneath them. There it goes.
You're scaring the ducks.
Oh. Okay. Same situation. Breathing under control. Now my body's already acclimated somewhat. So I don't have to go through all that again, but if you did, same thing, get your breathing under control. But once you have your breathing under control, get back up on the ice, the way you came in, and get your picks out, have these around your neck, so you can just get out like this. Same thing, you're trying to get up on the ice like this, and you can see,
much easier.
How much faster that is.
Much easier.
To get to
awesome.
Safer area.
That is absolutely awesome. Now, when you look at something, now, Adam, we need to talk about this.
Yeah,
now,
I got time. Let's talk, Larry.
I'm going to tell you something. When you look at spending $500 to $600 on an ice locator, $800 to $1,200 on a portable shelter, $4,000 to $12,000 on a four wheeler, are you absolutely kidding me?
$489.
Are you got to be kidding me? So, I mean, that's what I'm saying. You know, it's all about using your head. Yeah, of course, everybody thinks that they're never going to go through. But you know what? If it never happens, that's a great thing. But if it does, look at how much easier that made
his slide.
And, you know, again, I hate to say this, but this guy's in pretty dang good shape, right?
Yeah.
I mean, so, you know, not everybody that ice fishes is as good a shape. You know, there's a lot of older people, a lot of people right. overweight that are not going to be able to get themselves out without them picks.
Right.
I'll
and it still takes quite a bit of upper body strength.
It did.
Especially if you're, you know, you're cramping up like I was right there. But it's much easier to do
with the picks.
Without them, especially if you don't have snow or anything on that ice.
Right.
My God, it's so slippery, it's hard to even get a grip on that.
You know,
now, you have about 10 minutes of fight time before you start to lose the grip in your hands, before you start losing that muscle control.
Yep.
And as time goes on, you're gonna start losing muscle control for your arms and your legs. And eventually, most people can last up to 45 minutes to an hour, depending on some variables, you know, outside
right.
water temp and stuff,
right.
before you lose consciousness. So getting out, you got 10 minute to 15 minute window right there to concentrate your efforts to get out. So it's a lot more time than you would think, but there's still a small window before things go bad where you can't.
Right.
And if you can't get out after 15 minutes or so,
you're in deep trouble.
Right. There's
right.
a couple options. Hopefully rescue gets there and they can come get you. Or worst case scenario, if nobody's around and nobody's coming, and this is last hopes, is you try to get as much as your body up on the ice. Actually, I'll show you.
I think he's starting to like this.
Okay. Oh yeah. All right, so no help is coming, and you can't get up. You've lost all your will, and all you can do is get up here like this. What you want to do is just try to stay as still as much as you can, and
you're gonna freeze.
You're gonna freeze. Your arms will lock into this ice, because being found like this unconscious at least still gives you a chance to be viable if rescue does come eventually, compared to going unconscious and going under.
That is a very, very good tip right there. So I never even knew.
This takes no effort right here. And it, like my legs, see my legs right now?
Right.
Even with this ice armor suit?
Yep.
I'm not doing anything. That's natural buoyancy of just this ice armor suit.
Coming up like that.
Right. All I have on here is blue jeans and my ice armor suit, just like you and my, and these are steel-toed work boots. Because everybody always asks, well, what if you had heavy boots on? Well, look at that. I'm not even doing that. That's
right.
My body doing that. And like I said, there's no protective gear on. And this sucks a lot, but this is natural. Like right now, I'm pushing my legs down on purpose. But if I just relax, my legs will come up.
That's a good safety tip for sure, right there.
A lot of these suits have like Striker, some of these other ones have inflatable
flotation
in them. But even without that, a lot of ice stuff that we wear, not typically denim like Carhartt or things like that, but your ice armor stuff has got enough down in it where there's some natural buoyancy for a while before it gets completely saturated and then it'll sink. So yeah.
Well, you did a great job. Thanks, Adam.
Yeah.
Let's go. Let's go get ice fishing.
You want to do your nebulous thing?
Oh, you did such a fine job here. I'll throw it to you.
I think I'm on the clock. I think I got like 9 more minutes before I lose all my function. All right. I'm in out of here one more time. That's it for me.
Do the ice pick thing. That was so impressive how fast you could get up and get out.
Yeah, I'm going to do it again because I'm tired.
Right.
So even with that ice breaking, the picks will still work to keep my head up here.
Now you gotta look at this, is the third time he's been in.
Yep. My body strength is going down.
You're getting
all that. Your body up on top of that ice is key.
Nice job.
I gotta get in the ambulance. I can't feel my legs.
Okay. That's the key right there to get them clothes off.
Right.
Because that's going to freeze instantly.
Right. If it's windy out here and that wind chill's dropping things,
you
want to get wet clothes off as quick as you can.
Right.
It's better to be shirtless on the ice, and that sounds crazy, than it is to wear wet, soggy clothes. Because this sucks your body heat right out.
That's
better
a good
off
tip.
Being bare skin.
Great tip.
All right.
All right. Now, I'm going to demonstrate one of the greatest devices I think there is for ice fishermen. They're about $450 bucks. It's a Nebulous, not a sponsor of Larry Smith Outdoors, but it's a product that we use and don't have a problem buying. What happens is, as soon as you hit the water, that this thing is going to open up. You can pull the rip cord on it, and it'll hold up to 1,000 pounds of weight. So, and then you can just get up into that. You know, which is a great way if you have it on your ATV that keeps your ATV or snowmobile from going down, because it will hold up 1,000 pounds. Hey, how am I going to even go through? You broke all the good ice.
Oh, yeah. There's plenty.
Yourself up
and it gets you out of that water. And then obviously, you can get yourself to shore. So, and again, it's a pretty cool device.
Ooh, that's a little cold.
Really?
That's a little cold.
I gotta try it one more time now without the nebulas. That was impressive how fast you got out.
I'll tell you, those picks are lifesavers. Now that nebulous lure, you can hook that up to your four-wheeler in a lot of lakes like Madison.
Yep.
Those count for flotation.
Right.
So that actually can suspend your
ATV. It folds up to such an easy little pack. You know, the great part is you can throw it in your shelter. You can carry it, put it in a bucket. You know, like I said, I mean, it's such a safety tool. It's the best thing that I could ever think of, you know?
Absolutely.
It is amazing, Adam, when you're in here, how your body does kind of acclimate to that temperature. Float up like this.
Yeah.
Instead of sitting here struggling all the time, let your body acclimate to it. Like you said, let your feet come up. I just wanted to make sure I could still do it.
Yeah, well, you did. Good job. That's like you said, it's warmer. After I got my sweatshirt off, I'm partly numb, but it tells you right there, get that wet clothing off. It's not terrible.
You know, the big thing, too, you guys, is ice fishing has become such a popular sport over the last 10 years. It's amazing how this sport has grown. And obviously, the more people that you get involved with ice fishing, the more chances there's going to be of people breaking through the ice. So, you know, that's why we're doing these things.
Absolutely.
Woo!
What do you think? Ever go in the ambulance and get warmed up?
I'd like to do it one more time.
All right, do it.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Not that, and the only reason I want to do it one more time, you guys, is because I want to see how many times I can do it before I can't do it anymore.
Sure. If you want to go in, and we have the fire guys come in and play out, too.
I'd like to do it one more time because I'm already, you know what, my body's getting weaker already,
for sure,
so let me do it again.
Got it.
I'm gonna try it one more time.
I think the cold water is getting to you.
Probably is. Woo. One more time.
Crazy how fast it sucks
it
out of you.
It does. It sucks the life right out of you. I hate to say this. I'm not as good a shape as you are.
Sure you are, Larry.
Right.
Don't be so hard on yourself.
I might be better looking.
Yeah.
All right. Last time.
Thank you. thing.
Okay. Unless one of you guys want to go in and rescue me. No? One says no, one says yes. What we're going to do now is that's, I don't know how many times I go in. I'm already starting to lose
four,
it.
Yeah, four,
four times. And I'm going to go in, and Mitch is going to come in and save me and show you what happens. You know, when you do, when you're in the water and a rescue squad's coming, don't panic, don't fight them. You know, and that's, I think that's the biggest thing. So let's see how that goes. Definitely the last time. Mitch, you ready?
Ready.
Mitch, I got a nice donut in the truck. I stopped at the greatest place in the world for donuts. Oh, yeah. I'm going to buy Mitch a donut, you know.
So what he's doing is he's approaching from behind like that in case somebody were to try to pull the rescuer down. You come from behind, keep your rescuer safe, clip a rope on, and then the team on shore pulls both out at the same time.
Thanks, Mitch.
Yeah, I appreciate it.
Now we're going to the next step, is we're going to go in and take us into the ambulance and check our body heat.
So we've got him dried off as best as we can. We've actually got a heating gown on. He's going to sit down on the cot right here.
Okay.
And we're going to hook him up to the heater. Key thing is to get him dried off. Right now we've also got some warm air. We're going to go ahead and lay down. We're going to blow some warm air up through his gown. And then we're also going to put some heat packs in his groin and his armpits.
So this is actually a heater going through there now.
This is actually a bear paw heater.
Okay.
This blows heated air. It'll blow it through this heating pad through this. This is something we use in the emergency department for hypothermic patients. And we also use them a larger model. And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to put these heat packs in a pillowcase so there's not direct skin contact, which can run the risk of burning him because right now he can't feel a lot of what his skin is undergoing because he's a little bit numb. So I don't want to burn him. So we're going to put these in this thin layer before we apply them to his groin.
Look at the shake. Make sure you get the shakes. He's shaking like crazy. Look at it.
Yep. So the shivering is the body's way of warming itself. And the problem is once you lose that compensation.
So once you stop shivering, you stop shivering, then you're in deep trouble, huh?
Then you're in rough shape at that point because you're not able to generate any body heat.
Okay.
And when you get into that moderate to severe hypothermia, you really lose your brain power in addition to your muscle power.
Okay. And if in that situation, Doc, that somebody does suck in that cold water, what can be done?
So
they're
going to cough a lot.
Okay.
That's okay.
Yep.
And then what we would do in the hospital is we would be, you know, making sure their oxygen saturations are good and those types of things. And
right.
Then chest x-ray and probably bring them in the hospital overnight and make sure they don't develop a pneumonia. Antibiotics is, there's a lot of nasty bacteria and all kinds of stuff in any type of dirty water.
Right.
Like that.
Yep. Hey, I'll tell you, that pretty much concludes our ice rescue, and we definitely thank the Janesville Fire Department and Rescue for helping us out. And Adam, we thank you for help having us come down here and go through this experience. Anything you want to say to our audience before we close this off and go out and do a little bit of crappie fishing?
Well, it was my pleasure having you down here, and I think spreading this message is very important. Like I said, the video that we did a couple years ago, it went out there, but I think with the people we're trying to hit with your show, the message is really going to spread. That safety message is important. A couple of things that we didn't touch on that I think are also important is remember, always let somebody know where you're going.
travel with partner if you can, and on new ice, make sure that you stay somewhat separated.
Right.
On new ice, we always carry a life jacket in our sled. We don't might wear it, but we have it, and we have a throw rope at least 50 feet along with our ice picks, which we have on. That way, if your partner does go in, you have a throw rope and a life jacket, you can at least get to him in a, without risking your safety, try to pull him out. And in whatever case, it's still an emergency, so make sure you still call 911 and get that person taken care of once they get out. Because hypothermia can hit you even if you're not in the water. It can hit you when you're trying to get off the lake, too.
Right.
So very important things. Again, you can check our guide service out, Pikepole Fishing. We got the original video of that, but I think today went much better.
Good.
So it was very informative. So
hey, you know what I say?
What's that?
Let's go catch some fish.
Let's do it.